Hello everyone, welcome to Quilts and Roses. In this video, I'll be showing you how to decoupage a cup and a saucer. And the interesting thing is, this cup and saucer, you can use it. So let's get started. I'll be using tissue paper. This beautiful tissue paper has many flowers in that, and I'll be cutting the flowers of my own choice. The only thing you have to keep it in your mind is you have to cut it precisely. Okay? By the end of the video, I'll be telling you what to use so that you can use this cup and saucer for your daily use, okay? You can easily drink tea in that. You can wash it, not an issue at all. Once you have cut the tissue paper, keep it aside. I'll be applying this golden border around the rim of your cup. For that, you have to make a template out of the tape so that the golden color you are applying does not cross over. Okay? It should have a proper margin. So carefully stick the tape around the rim for all the cups. I'll be just applying the border for the cups, not the saucer this time. Take a little time to place the tape accordingly so that it looks even all around the rim. And once you have stuck the tape, start painting the golden color around the rim, okay? And before it is dry, once you have painted all around, before it gets dry, take a tissue paper, wrap it around your finger, and just wipe whichever paint you see on the top of that area. Okay? Wipe them and then let it dry for some time. I left it as such for at least 3 hours so that it was completely dry. So once this is done, take your floral cutout or your design, peel off the extra ply which the tissue paper usually have, and fix it on the saucer or on the plate, whichever you are doing, decoupaging, okay? Once you have decided how to put it, where to stick it, apply the glue. Apply a very thin coat of glue, let it dry for 5 seconds, and then fix your cutout. Once it's positioned properly, take the glue and apply again a thinner coat on top of your cutout and let it dry. Be very gentle while you're doing it, okay? And keep it aside, let it dry completely. So here's the one which I have finished. And it's dry now completely. You can see there's not much of shine on this cup, on the floral area. So I'll tell you what to be done next. If you notice, when we apply the glue, you see a little bit of glue is left outside. We apply it so as the glue is outside the margins of your flower. But when you are going to finish it, when you're going to give a finishing touch, that glue gives a very ugly look to your decoupaged item. So what you have to do is scrape off those glue with any of the sharp thing. Like for example, you can use your X-Acto knife. In this case, I'm just using the scissor, which is quite pointed. But be careful so that you are not removing any portion of your tissue paper. Just the extra glue you're removing, okay? Similarly, you have to do it on your saucer also. In the saucer, you will see the flower which I have stuck there, the tissue paper, has little more shine. That's because I have applied 2 layers of decoupage glue on top. There was no reason to do that. I just want to show you the difference it gives when you apply one more layer of glue on top of the flower, okay? This also I have to scrape a lot of glue, extra glue outside the cutout which I had already stuck there. So here it's all clean now, all the extra glue is removed. Now this is something which we are going to use next. So this is triple thick from DecoArt. It gives a very glossy look on your cup and saucer. You shake it properly. One tip I would like to tell you is don't use it directly on the decoupage item. You have to dilute it. As the name suggests, it is quite thick. And I'll show you the difference at the end of the video, how it looks if you directly use it without diluting and after dilution how it looks. Okay? What is the difference? I'll be telling you at the end of the video. Stay tuned for that. So once you have diluted it, mix it very well so that the thickness has been reduced to at least 1/3. Once you have mixed it properly, start applying it in a gentle motion. Give an even smooth coat with your brush. Preferably use an acrylic brush so that it gives a very nice smooth look. Similarly, apply it on your saucer also. One more thing I'd like to tell you is don't leave the handle of your cup, okay? Even on the handle, you have to apply the varnish. Once you have applied it, keep it to dry. You can see the glossy look on the saucer. You see that? It's beautiful. Now let this sit and dry for at least 48 hours. Don't touch it until it's 48 hours. Let it dry completely. Now I'll be showing you the ones which is already dried for me. These are the ones which I have done a few days back so that I can show you now. You see the shine, you see the gloss. It looks perfect to me. You can use this cup, you can pour tea, you can pour your coffee, no problem. You can drink, you can wash. The only thing is you don't have to dip it in the water, don't soak it in the water and wash, no. You have to be gentle while washing, but you can wash it, that's the main thing. You see, this plate is the one which I have diluted the triple thick and I have applied an even coat on this. Similarly, I'll show you the other one which I have not diluted. You will see a lot of difference. This triple thick is quite thick and make sure to dilute the triple thick before applying it to the saucer or the cup. In this saucer, if you will notice that there are brush strokes, you can see the brush strokes are visible. You see that? And you don't want that. That does not give you a neat look. Those brush strokes are visible because I did not dilute. Meanwhile, on this one, I have diluted the triple thick and used it. The difference is noticeable, quite noticeable. You will see a lot of difference in both of them. So make sure to dilute the triple thick and use it. If you want, you can apply even 2 coats of it. Make sure to apply the second coat only when the first coat is completely dry. So you need to give a gap of at least 24 to 48 hours. So this is the video for today. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you have any doubts, feel free to comment below. Don't forget to hop onto the description box. There are amazing discount coupons there. So it's time to wind up now. I'll be back with another DIY video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.